Hello everyone, welcome back to my channel. Today in this video I'm going to be talking about good reasons for not caring. But before you get into this video, subscribe. I have a lot of different content on various topics. I give advice on different things. I talk about biblical things. I do a lot of art videos, like showing some of my art, and I do cooking videos and various other things. So if you're interested, subscribe. With that being said, here are the top five good reasons for not caring. Number one, don't care about what people think about what you're doing, what you've done, what people think about you in general, or your life, your lifestyle. Don't care about what people think. And there's a certain extent to not caring about what people think, because people can try to give you advice or can try to correct you, and that's all fine and dandy. But when a person is just over concerning themselves with your life and the way that you do things, and they're just really coming at you in a very negative way, trying to bring you down and just giving you their opinions on your life and their thoughts that don't really matter, and it's just really starting to weigh on you, just let it all go. Drop it. Ignore that person. Don't care about what they think, because it will only cause you even more harm. Or if you know you're trying to make a change or become better in different things, and this person is just coming at you and is not helping, just don't care. Stop caring. Just wipe it all away, ignore them, and go on with your life. Don't care about what people think, because it can be distracting. But if someone is giving you their thoughts and opinions from a sincere heart, and they're trying to help you, and they're trying to really give you some good advice to help you get out of a certain circumstance or better yourself in certain areas that you may have overlooked, then that's fine and dandy. You can accept that. But when a person is commenting on you in a very negative way, stop caring. Number two, don't care so much about how you look, trying to look awesome or over the top, and just trying to look your ultimate best all the time. There's nothing wrong with trying to look nice, or presenting yourself in a way that's elegant, different things like that. There's nothing wrong with doing that. But some people just go over the top. They waste a lot of time, unnecessary time, trying to just look their best, putting on makeup and doing all of these different things just to go to Walmart, just to go to the store or go to the park or something simple like that. They'll waste a lot of time doing that, and it's very vain, in my opinion. Like I said, there's nothing wrong with, fixing yourself up so you don't look like a fool, or so you don't just look raggedy or anything like that. It's nothing wrong with that at all. But some people just, they go way out, just way out. And it's not necessary. It's just be your normal self. Be casual. You don't have to be over the top. I can even go on to say how you look doing things. So like if you're just doing a simple job, don't worry about just looking weird doing your job. Like let's say you're raking the leaves on a nice fall day or something, and you just think you look so weird with this huge rake trying to rake leaves, and you're just conscious about who might be walking by your yard, and you're just always looking, trying to make sure you don't look weird doing it. Or you're doing something else that you might think you may look weird about, and it really starts to distract you from what you're really supposed to be doing. Don't worry about looking stupid when you're supposed to be doing something that's important, or when you're just going about life. Like some people are insecure about running because they think they look stupid running. But running is fun sometimes, or running can get you places faster. And everybody runs. Everybody looks different when they run. And there's no big deal having someone see you run. So there's just different things like that that you do in life. And if you concern yourself with just caring ultimately all the time about what you think someone may think you look like doing this particular thing, and it's just weighing on your mind, it takes up space in your brain, and it's just overall not even necessary. And be confident in your casualness. If you're not one to be very fashionable or really care about what others think you look like doing certain things, project that confidence. Be confident in that so that you don't ever feel bad if someone do look at you like. You don't have to feel bad if someone wants to pick on you or say you look like this when you run or you look like that when you jump or you look foolish doing this or you look dumb doing that. If people make fun of you, say those kind of things, just ignore them. Ignore them and keep your confidence. Number three, don't care about what you desire versus what you need. And here's what I mean. A lot of people just concern themselves so much with the things that they want, the things that they desire, but not really need. It's so much more important to focus on the things that you need in life versus the things that you desire. Because if you focus on the important things, like maybe bettering yourself and getting yourself together, seeking the Most High, making sure you're living a righteous life, different things like that, making sure you're financially sustained, make sure you have good mental health, make sure you have good physical health. There's just so many more important things that you need to focus on versus things that you might want. Now, there's, of course, different things that you need to work towards to get. There's definitely a certain amount of time that you have to focus on the things that you want, because otherwise, in some cases, you might not even get the things that you may want or desire if you don't work towards getting it or pray about getting it or different things like that. But when I say don't care about the things that you desire versus the things that you need, there's a reason, because most times when people focus on their desires, they end up going down the wrong path, really trying to get those things. And you can end up in sin trying to get the thing that you desire, because most times when you desire something, you can desire it so much to where you end up in sin. Or it could be a good thing that you desire, but there's other ways that you can get that thing that's sinful. So there's different ways that you can get the things that you desire or care about or concern yourself with the things that you desire, but don't be driven away by it. Focus on the things that are important more than the things that aren't important so that you can stay in line. Don't care about what others are doing. If you see someone doing this or doing that, or they got this and they got that, don't concern yourself with that. Don't concern yourself with how someone is living their life and going about doing things to the point to where you can't even focus on what you're supposed to be doing, how you can go about life, how you can get things. If you're constantly concerning yourself with how this person is gonna get through that or do this or get this or how this person is gonna get there, you're gonna be too mixed up and stressed to even worry about yourself. Now, you can help a person. You could put a person in their place respectfully, or you could, like if it's affecting you in some way, you could, you know, tell that person about themselves. If they're doing something that's wrong, you could tell them that, but don't concern yourself to the point to where you can't even focus on what it is you should be doing. Don't care about what others are doing before you care about what yourself is doing. Because there's so much more that you can be doing versus caring about what others are doing. Focus on your life, getting your life together, and staying in Yah's will, living a life that's righteous. Focus on those things before you concern yourself with someone else's life. Which brings me to number five. Don't care about having a picture-perfect life. getting everything that you want, doing everything that you want, having all the right picture-perfect people in your life. Don't care about those things, because 9 times out of 10, your life isn't going to be picture-perfect. There's going to be things that happen in your past or in your future that you can't change. Whatever Yah's will is His will, and He's going to bring it about. So don't concern yourself with having a picture-perfect life of just beauty and perfection. Just try your best to live perfect in Yah's word, or obeying His commandments and walking righteously in His ways. You can concern yourself with being spiritually perfect and striving for perfection when it comes to His word and living a righteous life. But for the most part, don't care about having a picture perfect life, because you will never have a picture perfect life. All have sinned and fall short of the glory of the Most High. So that means your sins aren't going to look perfect. So regardless to how you paint yourself out to be, you're not going to be perfect either. So regardless to how you try to paint your life out to be, try to make it seem like you have just this awesome, perfect life, your life is never going to look perfect. So don't concern yourself about having this picture-perfect lifestyle, because 9 times out of 10, it's just not going to look that way. It's not going to flow that way. You're going to have ups and downs. You're going to have tribulations and trials. You're going to go through things like any other human being would. And your life just isn't going to look perfect. So if you concern yourself and just overly care about making your life appear to be perfect, you'll waste a lot of time. You'll look vain to others. People look on and be like, and just see that you're just so vain in the way you live, the way you go about your lifestyle. But if you concern yourself with the more important things rather than just trying to be a picture perfect person with a picture perfect life, you'll be better off. So that was my top 5 good reasons for why you should stop caring about certain things. Because it's very important not to concern yourself too much with things that aren't important. And a lot of times people overly care about these particular things that I listed. And it's either vain, time consuming and wasteful, or distracting. So I hope this video was helpful. I hope the information and tips in this video helped you a lot, and I hope you apply it to your life. So with that being said, comment if this video was helpful. Let me know in the comment section below if there's any other subjects like this that I should cover on my channel, and I'll try my best to do a video. With that being said, look in the description box for more information, or check my community where I post helpful scriptures, photography, poems, and more. You might also enjoy that information as well. So with that being said, thanks for watching. Don't forget to subscribe, comment, share, and like.